be the boss.
A bobber is a solo ride. It's a bike configuration that says, this is my time, my space, my pace. And so it is with Triumph's Bonneville 1200 Bobber. It's a gorgeous looking, individualistic piece of engineering. On the open road or rambling around a city, it's a bike that clearly asserts a huge personality. We find it hard to fathom the heartland of the Triumph brand. Others also have a range of sports, road, adventure, and classic bikes, but somehow, it's really only when you look at their classics that we feel that Triumph has got something that almost no other mark has, a traditional personality, and a British one at that. Arresting looks, brilliant pieces of nostalgic detailing, engine specifications that focus on character, and a heritage all make this a really differentiated offer. The Bobber works with the 1200cc twin, often referred to as the Bonneville. It produces about 75 brake horsepower, so this is an engine more thunderous in sound than in power, but it's plenty to keep the 230kg bike moving around nicely. In town, going around country roads, the bike has a lovely blend of torque and agility. If you go much above 70 miles per hour, though, you'll find yourself extremely challenged by the flow of air against you. This is a bike to potter around on, not to hurry anywhere with. That's also seen in how, if you're pressing a bit too hard and come across a rough surface, the forces through the suspension and into your seat can hit pretty hard. This really is a bike made for the spiritual lift it gives you with each ride, rather than its dynamic ability. It goes well and stops well enough, but the real transport is of your mind, to a state where you're grinning with the great exhaust note, content to be moving along in a sprightly fashion, aware of how good the retro silhouette looks, and content to be biking in an uncomplicated way. There's absolutely a place for this type of biking experience, and in its glorious khaki green here, this Bobber is a brilliant bit of modern retro engineering that you can enjoy every day. There is a black edition, which sports a few more of the 130 or so customizable parts that are on their list, and which also has uprated dual disc front brakes. The standard bike we tried didn't exactly pin your nose to the road with its braking ability, but it stopped the bike in a dependable, quietly understated British fashion. Kay and Dave, who helped film this episode, enjoyed the bike's presence and noticed how it caught everyone's eye as we passed by, even in the central business district of Johannesburg, which is really not a place you'd often attract an admiring glance. What do we think of this Triumph Bonneville Bobber?
I think it's pretty tough. As soon as you switch it around, it just sounds so raw.
And it gets going quickly. Like, for a small bike like that, I mean, the horsepower it has, it's very quick to get up to speed.
It's really hard to evaluate that bike because it's a 1200cc.
Yes.
You know, so you think, well, that's going to cost quite a lot. But it's only kind of 70-ish horsepower.
Exactly.
So then it's not a super
bike.
And then
with mediocre braking and all that, it's like it's sitting in the strange area where you're like, it should be more or it should be less. It's not. It's.
So what's the verdict on this one, guys? Would you buy it?
For me, I don't know if I would buy it, but I kind of appreciate it for what it is. Like, this is my first bobber style bike, and just this whole single seater. Yeah. It feels cool.
So would you have this bike, Kay?
Just from the way it looks. Yeah, I would. I think it's a really beautiful looking bike.
We are grateful to Triumph Johannesburg, who really couldn't have treated us better.
Tell us a bit about why you're a bike.
It's something different. So it's not American, it's not German, it's not Japanese. It's a brand that appeals to me as a person. It's something that I'm comfortable to sell on and gives us that unique kind of individual proposition.
If you wanted this bike as an animal, which animal would it be in?
Probably a warthog.
Oh, right.
Yeah. That's a short, stocky, aggressive Yeah, they're brilliant. Thank you very much. That's nice to meet you too.
Would we have one of these bikes? Well, our mission is always to find the boss in every bike. And in the Bobber's case, you can have a really handsome machine which makes even the most mundane little ride something of an event. So, absolutely yes, this would be one for the garage. Go try one out. It's a Warthog, independent, characterful, and sporting remarkably distinctive looks.